Hi, I'm Scott Howard, and today I'm going to give a demonstration of the VAST Data Global Namespace functionality. The Global Namespace feature allows you to access the same data set across multiple VAST clusters in multiple locations, whether those clusters are local, halfway across the world, or even in the cloud using VAST on cloud. Global Namespace is relevant for many different workloads, but the one we're going to show today is using it to carry out some video editing across multiple locations. As all clusters in the global namespace have fully consistent read-write access to the data, we can have multiple editors working on the same data set at local speeds, despite being on the opposite side of the country or even the world. While the data space supports many clusters in a mesh topology, today we're going to stick with a simple example which utilizes two VAST clusters, one of them in San Francisco and the other on the other side of the country in New York. That's around 2,500 miles, or about 70 milliseconds of network latency between the two clusters. In addition to the VAST clusters, each location has a Linux system that we're going to be using to access the local VAST cluster over NFS. We're using Linux and NFS for today's demo to keep it simple, but we also support multi-protocol access to the data, even at the remote sites. So let's jump into our VAST GUI and have a look at the setup we have there. If I go into the data space configuration, we can see that I've got two VAST clusters linked, and I've got a single slash video directory configured as the global namespace between the two. The data in this directory is owned by the San Francisco cluster, but is available across both of them. Next, let's go to the Linux system in San Francisco. We've already got that global namespace directory mounted from the VAST cluster in San Francisco, but as you can see, the directory is empty. So let's copy in the video files that we're going to be working with. We've got about a dozen source files there, totaling a few gigabytes of data. Now let's go into our video editor and add those video files to a new project. As you can see, as I do that, the files come up near instantly as they're on the VAST cluster that's local to the system. Next, I'm going to create a quick project made up of a few of those clips. And then we'll save that project in the same global namespace directory that the videos themselves are in. Now, up to this point, we've been working on a single VAST cluster, the one in San Francisco. But now let's jump over to the New York system and have a look there. If I look in the GUI for the New York VAST cluster, I see the same global namespace relationship set up. Only this time, it's showing as being the destination or the satellite system for my data. So the data doesn't permanently reside there, but it will be intelligently transferred and cached as required. In this case, I've configured the satellite to use a different directory for the data than on the origin, just to make it a little clearer which system is which. So slash video on the origin maps to slash video global on the satellite, although I could have made those directory names to be the same if I'd wanted to. If I jump into the Linux system in New York, if I cd into that directory and do a listing, you'll notice there's a very slight pause as the metadata I'm accessing is copied between the systems. But if I do the same directory listing again, then the response is almost instantaneous, due to the satellite system caching the results from the first access. As you can see, both the video files and the project file that I saved in San Francisco system are visible. So let's jump into our video editor and load up that project. When I open the project, you'll see that the video editor starts to read in those various video files. And you might notice that there's a slight pause as it does that, due to the data having to be fetched from San Francisco. But with our intelligent prefetching and caching of the data, it still comes up very quickly. If I'd known in advance I was going to be working on this specific data set on this cluster, I could have told the system to pre-cache that data into the satellite to avoid that slight lag. But even without doing that, the process is still dynamic and the data will be moved between the systems as required. Now, New York is where my video editors work. So let's come in and make some edits to my movie. We can splice and reorder a few of the clips, and maybe add some transitions, and perhaps even a filter. Okay, so now we've made those changes, let's click on Save, which will write the new project files back to the global namespace path. But despite the fact that I'm writing to the New York cluster, those changes will automatically make their way back to the San Francisco cluster, as that's the origin cluster for this path. To confirm that, let's jump back to the San Francisco system and reopen the project file that we just saved in New York. And as you can see, all of the changes that we made are there as expected. In fact, due to our strong consistency model, the changes are instantly visible on every system in the global namespace the moment they're written on any other cluster. Thank you for joining us today to explore the global namespace functionality of the VAST Data Platform. We demonstrated how data can be seamlessly accessed and edited across multiple locations in real time. If you'd like to dive deeper into our features and innovations, be sure to check out our other videos and resources. Thanks for watching.